各位朋友，我们的甜品叫做开司徐妈已经做好了，肯定很好味道的。那我们的这一个甜品，它的来历是什么呢？当时奥宗，就是奥匈帝国的女皇茜茜公主，她呢非常喜欢苗条，所以她当时也不想吃那些带有奶酪还有牛奶的那些蛋糕。他喜欢吃，但是呢他也不想长胖啊，所以呢他就喜欢吃像这样子的一个甜品，是他们的宫廷的厨师为他特别制定的，当时的名字叫凯瑟琳曲玛。最后呢他老公 Franz Josef 也喜欢吃这个东西，每一次去打猎的时候都叫他们做这个东西给他吃，最后所有的人就开始命名为这个甜品叫做凯瑟曲玛。茜茜公主呢，她当时其实很喜欢吃那个萨赫多特还有那个德玛多特，但是她又不想长胖啊，所以她就还是就叫她的宫廷厨师为她做了这一个美美的而且又健康的叫做凯瑟曲玛的甜品。各位朋友，你们也不妨可以试一下啊。
Now I'm going to show you how to prepare Kaiser Schmarrn. If you translate it, hard to translate maybe, it's a sweet pancake that you chop. So this is, it's not one piece, it's many tiny pieces. And I show you what ingredients you need. You need flour, eggs, raisins, butter, milk, sugar,and just a tiny little bit of salt, and I show you afterwards. You put apples or plum marmalade next to it. And I explain you the story of the Kaiser Schmarrn, double R. It was meant to be a dessert, a sweet,for the wife of the late Emperor Franz Josef. Her name was Sisi. You probably heard the name before, quite a famous figure in Austrian history. A beautiful woman who was very careful to stay slim. So she didn't want all these heavy, creamy tarts or Mehlspeisen, as we call it. She wanted something to stay slim, but yet sweet.So they invented for her the recipe of the Kaiserschmarrn, and it was first called the Empress Schmarrn. Schmarrn just means something mixed together. And as the emperor himself, her husband, saw it and tasted it and liked it so much that he wanted it to be served whenever he was hunting on his hunt,they called it, after the emperor, Kaiser's Schmarrn, the emperor's mix together of sweet. So, I'm gonna show you now how to prepare this historical Schmarrn. The raisins. The eggs.A little bit of milk.